Previously, I was able to revive my old motherboard. Now let's try to build a budget gaming PC out of it, reutilizing some parts while keeping our budget under $200. Let's do this. Before we begin, let's take a look at some of the bargain parts I've purchased and parts that I reutilized from my old PC. For the PC parts purchased, I bought a bundled used but in good condition Inwin 103 casing and a Be Quiet CPU cooler for $30. A used Silverstone 700 watts 80 plus rated power supply for $15. $50 for a used Intel Core i7-7700 processor. A used but good condition Zotac GTX 1060 6GB AMP Edition graphics card for $50. Pair of 16GB each. DDR4 2400MHz RAM modules, total of 32GB memory for $40. And three pieces brand new 120mm pulse width modulation, hydraulic bearing type casing, fans. Sorry, RGB fans, no RGB lighting for this build. Total spent, $193. For parts that I didn't purchase and already have, taken from my previous build, a Gigabyte B250M motherboard, 512GB M2 NVMe PCIe storage for my primary storage, and 1TB IDE hard drive as secondary storage. So let's build this and see how it goes. I don't want to bore you with details on how I built it. So let's just speed things up, and I'll just label some important parts of the assembly process. At this point, I realized that the CPU cooler fan's orientation is incorrect. The fan should be blowing air towards the rear casing fan, so I'm fixing it and will also be replacing the 256GB NVMe drive with a 512 one. Now there you go, it may not be pretty, but it's all good for me. I'm not after some fancy looking RGB setup anyway. As long as it gives me decent performance, and for under $200, I'm not complaining. Now let's run some quick tests and see how it performs. Running core temp and MSI, afterburner, CPU, and GPU temps are looking good. Although I have observed one of the GPU fan is a bit slow than the other one, and been hearing some grinding noise. I've already ordered a fan replacement, and we'll have that for another video in the future. Let's do a quick game run on CS2. I'm leaving the settings to default, which is high settings, and see how it performs.
Let's roll.
So that's it, guys. My less than $200 gaming PC build. Can't wait to test more games on this build and see how it fares with other high-demanding games. Please comment down below what you think about this setup. Is this a good bargain? Or maybe I could do better. Let me know. And if you may, please hit the subscribe and like button. Appreciate it. Thanks, and have a great day.